Welcome to Fredo Ghost. This is Fredo. Fredo Ghost is a proxy framework for SketchUp. By a proxy framework, I mean the capability to replace an object, so a component or a group, by another object called proxy, and to switch back and forth between the original object and its proxy version. In Fredo Ghost, a proxy is called a ghost, and the original object is called a real object. So let's see how it works. You have here the toolbar of Fredo Ghost. The icon with the yellow gear invokes the main dialog box of Fredo Ghost, where you can select a method and make a ghost of any selected component. So let's take this component. The method is an X-ray with light green color. Let's make it a ghost. You can select another one, change the method, for example, grayscale, where here you have the chair component ghosted in grayscale. From there, you can switch back and forth between the ghost and the real. So you use these two buttons, red and green, the equivalent buttons in the main toolbar. So the green button converts to real, and the red button converts to ghost. The conversion applies to the selection. So if I select only this chair and I convert to real, only this chair is converted. When you have no selection, the conversion applies to any ghosted object under the active context. Let's convert this chair to ghost. And now what happens if I move the chair? And maybe I scale it. So, and now I convert it to real. You see that the real component has followed the ghost. Similarly, if you make a transformation on a real object, let's, for example, do this, the ghost object will follow. To remove the ghosting of a particular object, just select it and press this button that will suppress the ghost. The object will of course be first converted to its real version. Now this object has no ghost anymore, so if you try to convert it, you won't be able to do it. Okay, you can apply this globally at any level. And here you see that since there is no more ghost in the model, all the buttons are grayed out. Fredo Ghost is compatible with the native SketchUp Undo and Redo. So if I make this a ghost and this one in let's say pink, you if I now press Control Z, the last ghosting operation is cancelled, and if I press again Control Z, it is cancelled too. And if I redo with Control Y, I can restore the ghosting. So remember, use in Fredo Ghost for any operation, you can use the native undo and redo, Control Z, Control Y, or the buttons. By the way, all the information on ghosting is stored in the model, which means that If you copy the model, do a save as or save a copy as, the information is in the model and therefore will apply. You can customize a ghosted object with several methods. So let's take this pink chair. So we enter the ghost. So you see that Fredo ghost indicates you are within a ghosted object. We select another method. So let's take X-ray green, select a sub object, apply the ghosting. Now the ghost for this share combines two methods. Now Fredo ghost remembers this setup, and therefore, if you wanted to change the top method for ghosting the share, let's say to monochrome, it will preserve the sub object, the sub ghosting. Okay, you can override this by pressing Control while you press make ghost. So if I keep Control, you see that it had overridden the sub ghosting. You may want to modify a real object, so let's see what happened to the ghost. So first, let's take this share and convert it to real. Now let's modify it and, for example, remove one leg. As you can see, because the chair is a component instance and there are nine component instances, the leg is removed from all other instances as well. We are in the real world. As soon as you do that, you will notice that this button, which is a refresh button, is highlighted. So normally, if you do nothing, if you convert to ghost, the ghost will reflect the four legs. Now, if you refresh the ghost by pressing this button, now the ghost will have only three legs, and you notice that the other one, the other chair, which has a different method but also based on the same component definition, has one leg removed. So this is the refresh. Whenever you see this refresh button enabled, it's good to press it to refresh unless you have a good reason not to do it. You may want to create a copy of a component. So in its ghosted form, if you create a copy, it will inherit the ghost behavior. So the two chairs here in grayscale have now the ghosting behavior. If the component is in its real form, it works as well. So you see that the two chairs here in monochrome have the behaviors. Okay. This is an option which applies only to components which can be disabled in the default parameters, where you have inherit the ghost behavior when objects are copied. So if you are not happy with this default behavior, you can change it. This does not apply to a ghost, so to a group. So let's take this table, make it a ghost. Now, if I convert it to real and then copy it, you see that only the original one has the ghosting behavior, and this is normal because in the end these are two different objects since they are grouped. If now I copy the ghost, then only the original component group keeps the ghosting behavior, and this copy is a copy of the ghost and nothing else. Okay, so you cannot do anything with it, you cannot convert it to real. So remember, copying works for component and sense because it makes sense. For group, it does not. You may wonder what happens if you modify a ghost. Usually you would not, but let's say I want to modify this ghost. It may be accidental, so let's remove the back. So if you do that, then the next time you convert the object to real, you will be prompted with a confirmation. That is, Fredo Ghost has detected that you modified the ghost and wants to know if it is by accident, in which case you press no, you don't want to update it, or intentionally, in case you press yes. If you press yes, now when you convert it to ghost, the ghost, the new ghost, the modified ghost becomes the ghost. Okay, so this again may be what you want to do, or the confirmation box will prevent you to do it accidentally. FredoGhost comes with a set of methods split in three main categories. You have the styling method, so we've seen monochrome with pink, with a color like this one. You can also do a simple X-ray, okay, which preserves the textures and colors. You can also do a grayscale. The second category is about simplification of objects. For example, you can take this table and replace it by its single bounding box. You can also replace it by bounding boxes, but for each object or and sub-objects. Okay, so you see these two sub-objects. And you have also the no texture method, which can be useful to make the model lighter. So you suppress the texture of the object. You can customize the method, so press this button to manage the ghost method. So let's take X-ray. So you have a few parameters like the opacity. So let's make it very light. The color, let's make it red. And also you can manage the edge, either put them in black, in gray, or mix them with the face colors. So if I take this share, apply the ghosting, you see that you have a very transparent red chair. So you can do this for other methods. I forgot, for example, the wireframe method, where you can customize the edge color, but this assumes you are in a style where you can see the color of edge. But just to show what wireframe does, so this is more or less equivalent to the wireframe of SketchUp. as opposed to edge mesh, which will show all edges in the object. Okay, so wireframe only shows the contouring object. So you can customize also the grayscale or let's see masking. So if you have, let's convert first to this chair to its real version so you see better what it is. So masking is to apply a color mask, which you can take usually white or black. Okay, white to make it lighter and dark to make it black to make it darker with a desaturation factor. So you see that if I increase the desaturation here in the sample model, the color are more palish. Okay, it's more like a water print. So you can also apply an opacity if you wish. Okay, so let's desaturate a little bit, apply it, and you see that the type of rendering. One particular method gives you the freedom to replace a real object by any object picked in the model. So this method is called a proxy. So you need to customize it, of course, with choosing a proxy object in the model. So you can either select it from a list, like this kind of object. But the best is to select it in the model, and you can now use it. So let's take this share and replace it by the proxy. Of course, there is a problem of dimensioning because the proxy may not have the same scaling than the real object. In principle, this is not a problem in Fredo Ghost since you can modify the ghost object. So let's make it like this. Now, when you convert it back to real, you will be prompted for recording, saving the modification of the ghost. If you say yes, now the ghost will be at the right scale. One word about performance. It can take long for a heavy model to be converted to a ghost, especially if you use a method for styling, because you have to deal with every face and every edge. So let's see on this model how it behaves. First, here you have the current method, which is an X-ray light green. This button, if you have the dialog box closed, will generate the ghost for the selection with the current method. If you don't have a selection, you are asked for confirmation to apply the ghosting to the active context. So let's start this long process. You can interrupt it. Hein? You just need to click. You may want to abort the operation or continue. So let's wait for a moment. This is now finishing, and you see that the ship was ghosted in X-ray green. It took about 6 minutes to convert, to generate the ghost. Now the conversion, if you, I want to switch back to real, took 1/10 of a second. So in Fredo Ghost, the performance is good to convert, and it is as depending on the geometry to generate the ghost. When you no longer need ghosting in your model, you can purge the model from all data created by Fredo Ghost. So use this button or this button. You need to confirm explicitly by selecting yes, and the operation will apply. Of course, all ghosted objects will be first converted to their real form. Okay, as you can see, there is now no more ghosted object in the model. So this concludes this video, which gives an overview of the main features of Fredo Ghost. There are a few others which are more advanced and which I will cover in other videos. I will also cover in a specific video the details on the ghosting method. So thank you very much, and enjoy Fredo Ghost.